Petrus Christus, settled in Bruges in around 1444. He's coming in from other areas, and this is not unusual. And he's going to paint a goldsmith and his shop. Now, the image itself portrays Saint Eulogius sitting at his stall, showing a couple of set of rings. And this is straightforward enough as it is. It's a patron saint of goldsmiths doing his job. And really, the most sacramental element of his job, which is creating wedding rings. Now, the bride's betrothal girdle sits on a table. This is a symbol of chastity. In other words, she has been betrothed, and that girdle is a symbol of it. So it shows exactly what's happening. The only time you would take that off is once you're actually married, once you have the ring to symbolize it. And by the way, I should point out that those rings are something that is very new. Even today, wedding rings are a fairly recent idea. And in the Renaissance, only the very richest people would have gold rings. Everyone else would have something symbolic. You might have a ring made of some other material. Most people wouldn't have a ring at all. It just wasn't important. You knew if you were married, other people in your community, because you would have lived in a small community, probably knew if you were married. So it's not something that requires a ring, except in the upper classes. Now, the Eucharistic container and scales have religious connotations. The Eucharistic container being that it would hold the Eucharist after it had gone through the sacrament of turning from bread into the body of Jesus, and so was in and of itself a sacramental or highly religious item. The scales reflect good and evil. The same ideas that we see from religion, the idea that you must have more good than evil, or the scales of judgment at the end of one's life. Now, this may also have been a vocational painting for the Guild Chapel. The variety of items that we see are there to advertise what the guild can do. So we're looking at these items going, wow, look at all these things that this goldsmith can make. And it basically advertises the goldsmith's guild. If you need some of these items, come on down to us. We'll take care of it. And by the way, check it out. We paid for a chapel. We are good people. The same thing is happening in Northern Europe. This happened in Italy when it comes to the commissioning of artwork. They're using it to clean up their image. Now, the interesting element is this mirror. The mirror is intended to extend the space of the piece by revealing what is outside of the viewer's sight, creating a further illusion of reality. What it's really doing is a couple of things. First of all, it gives us an idea of a much larger world out here. And that's important because when you look around the world, you tend to see windows, you tend to see openings. Artists try to get away from those because they complicate things. But here he's embracing it. He's also showing people looking in, another couple. Again, getting at that idea of the sacred element of being a goldsmith. It also gives us setting. So it's one thing to be in a stall in an unknown city. It's another to look out at the architecture and be able to relate to it and go, yes, this is something happening in my town, in my area. And so you're going to be drawn into it. And thus drawn into the advertisement for the Gold Guild, as well as being drawn into a painting that is meant as a religious piece, balancing the secular and the sacred.